Morning, Nap. Well, just the Walton gang.
You come to see Yancy.
I don't know why you should be any different from anybody else in the county.
What does that mean?
Take a look. Right through that door.
Miss Langford, that is the most delicious piece of fried chicken I have sunk a tooth into in a right long time.
I remembered you like it crisp. Fix it special.
She showed up with it, said, Floyd, you got to get me over to see Yancy Tucker.
And I certainly appreciate it. Well, look who's in jail.
Hey, that's me.
Hey, how you doing, John?
John Boy.
How about some cake?
Thank you very much. Yes.
Well, pie. John Boy, you love pie.
Well, I do, but not now. No.
I even got some.
Oh, big breakfast.
Well, how about some Miss Blankford's fried chicken?
Thank you, that's fine. You're not gonna go hungry for a spell, are you, Yancy?
I could get life and not go hungry, thanks to good friends.
We gotta be moving along, Yancy.
Oh, what you leaving for, Floyd? Party's just getting in high gear.
Miss Blanket's got to get home to her children, and I got my work waiting.
Well, in that case, I'll let you go.
Let us know if you need anything, Yancy.
Thank you.
Keep up the faith, Yancy.
Oh, yeah.
Bye. Sure is delicious.
Bye now.
Don't come back.
All right.
See you, Sheriff.
Bye, Sheriff.
Bye, Sheriff.
Bye, y'all.
Well, I suppose I ought to get along, too. Got the lunch yet back at the place.
Miss Jane works at the Nip and Tuck Cafe over to Route 29.
Well,
she's the one who brought me the soup.
And the soup du jour of tomorrow is going to be black-eyed pea. You like, I'll bring you a jar.
You just bring your own sweet self.
Oh, yes. Bye. Bye, everybody.
Bye now.
We'll be seeing you.
Life would be a lonesome road without good friends.
Well,
Nancy, the reason we came by is because I thought I might be able to help you out.
What do you mean, help?
Well, I told my daddy everything, and if it's all right with you, we'd like to back you up.
Back me up?
You did take those chickens over to Potter's the other night, didn't you?
Yeah, but I didn't tell the sheriff that. I don't want to get John Boy involved.
Well, I'm already involved.
Well, not anymore, you're not. I promised you I'd take those chickens back. That's exactly what I did. You're off the hook.
Well, what about Charlie Potter getting shot?
Well, what about him? I didn't do it.
Well, then there's no point in my not telling the sheriff the rest of it, is
wrong, John Boy. There's every point. Don't you understand? There's no evidence I shot Charlie, and it'll be proved sooner or later.
Well, we can get you out of here right now.
No use hanging around here, Yancy.
Well, I've been in lots worse places than this. I got a nice warm bunk, got good food, plenty of friends dropping by. Not a bad place to spend a depression, come to think of it.
Nancy, you're crazy.
No, not so. Not so, John. Much as I like it here, I like my own place better. Look, the sheriff can't keep me more than a couple days. But if you tell him the whole story, he's got the goods on me for chicken thieving. He could lock me up then and throw away the key for that.
What would you like us to do?
Let nature take her course. Everything will work out for the best. It always does.